A very good morning, children. Hope you had a great weekend. So as I see that we discussed almost all the needed points considering this quiz in order to start exercise 6.1. I would like to start exercise 6.1 where we can complete this in the textbook itself. There is nothing more to, not that much to calculate. Everything is just concept oriented. So let us start with the first one, children. Just as I am doing in the textbook, you also do in the textbook and write with pencil so that when the mistakes comes, we can rectify it easily. So all the exercise 6.1 is going to be finished in the textbook itself. So please write in the textbook. So the first question is, what will be the unit digit of the squares of the following number? What will be the unit digit of the squares of the following numbers? That means when we take the given number and if we square it, square means multiplying the same number by itself. When we square it, the unit digit of that square is going to be what? That is the question. Okay. For that, no need to multiply the number by itself, because if we can check the last digit and square it, one square, okay, 1 into 1 gives us 1 back. So the unit digit will be 1. For the second one, the last or the unit digit is 2. So if we square it, 2 square is equal to 4. So the last digit of the respective square will be 4. Next, here the last digit is 9. So 9 times 9 is 81. So the last digit will be 1. Please be careful, not 81, last digit 1. Here 3853. Here the last digit is 3. So upon squaring 3, you will get 9. Now the fifth one. Here the last digit is 4. Upon squaring 4, 4, 4, 16. So the last digit is going to be 6. Okay, irrespective of the other digits, we will focus on the units digit. So here it is 7. So 7 square gives us 49. So 9 will be the digit in units place. Here it is 8. 8 times 8, 64. So 4 is going to be the digit in units place. Here we have 0. 0 square is again 0. So the last digit will be 0. Here we have 6. Upon squaring 6, that means 6 times 6 gives us 36. So the last digit will be 6 again. And the 10th one, here we have 5 at the units place. So 5 times 5 is 25. So the unit digit after squaring will also will be 5. Okay, hope you followed, children. So next I am going to second question. The following numbers are obviously not perfect squares. Give reasons. As you know, whenever the digits are 2, 3, I mean the unit digits are 2, 3, 7, 8 and the odd number of zeros, we can say that they are not perfect square. Here we have the 7 as n digit. So there is no chance of considering 1057 as a perfect square. Here we have 3 as the n digit. So no need to write again. Just keep this in mind. Since 3 is the unit digit of the given number, it will never be a perfect square. Here also we have 8 and here also we have 2. I discussed this point when I am explaining, children. You can find in your CW as well. Whenever the last digits are going to be 2, 3, okay, 7, 8 and the odd number of zeros, they will never be perfect squares. Here if you observe zeros, 3 zeros, so odd number of zeros. Simply write odd number of zeros. And here 2. Here also odd number of zeros. Odd number of zeros. Here last digit is 0, which is odd number, because last digit is 0 and that too it is odd number of zeros. So this is also not going to be a perfect square. Simple reasoning is required to solve this exercise, children. Next, third one. The squares of which of the following would be odd numbers? As you know, we discussed this, square of an odd number will always be odd. So here we have last digit 1, hence the square of it will also will be odd. Here we have an even number, so square of it will also will be even. Here we have odd number, so the square of it will be odd. Here 4, an even number, so the square of it will also will be even. Okay children, now the fourth one. Observe the following pattern and find the missing digits. So 11 square 121, in between 1 and 1 they kept 0. So in between this 1 and 2 and 2 and 1 they inscribed 1 zeros, because we have 1 zero here. In the like sense, okay, 1001 square, here it is having 2 zeros, so they kept 2 zeros in between 1 and 2 and between 2 and 1. In the like sense, 1, 2, 3, 4 zeros are there, so in between 1 and 2 we should put 4 zeros, and between 2 and 1 we should put 4 zeros. Okay, then they asked what is this going to be, that means how many zeros are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So in between 1 and 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros, then 2, again 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 zeros and 1. Very easy pattern. So let us move to next question children. So the fifth one is, observe the following pattern and supply the missing numbers. Okay. So the same, 11 square, 121, 101 square, 10201, okay, 10101 square. So if you observe 10203021, okay, so look, 10101, so 102030. Okay, as long as the number of ones are increasing, 1, 2, 3 ones are there. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, in between 1, 2, 3 they kept zeros, and the reverse of it they kept again. So here we have 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4 ones. So we have to write 10, 20, 30, 40, because we have 4 zeros. Now reverse of it, 30, 21. Okay, 30, 20 and 1. Now here look, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 40, 30, 21. Okay, so how many are there? 5 ones are there, so we have to take ones accordingly. 1 0 1 0 1 0 1 0 1. Okay, so 1 2 3 4 5 ones, which gives the resultant square of that number. Okay, now let us check that sixth question children. Using the given pattern, find the missing number. So 1 square plus 2 square plus 2 square is equal to 3 square. Check the next one, 2 square plus 3 square plus 6 square is equal to 7 square. If you observe clearly, this 1 multiplied by 2 gives us 2, 2 multiplied by 3 gives us 6. Okay, better you write here, 2 into 3 is equal to 6, 1 into 2 is equal to 2. Similarly, 3 into 4 gives us 12. Now 4 square, 5 square, they gave dash. Automatically 4 times 5 gives us 20, so here you will write 20. So 4 square plus 5 square plus 20 square is equal to 21 square. So 5 square plus dash square plus 30. So we know that 5 times 6 gives us 30. So here 6 square. Here 6 square plus 7 square. 6 into 7 is 42 square. Please look it carefully. 42 square. And here the resultant will be 43 square. Okay, we have to add 1 to 42 so that it will become 43. Very easy exercise children. Now check that seventh one. Even this is also the property which we have discussed. So without adding, find the sum. It is very much clear that 1, 3, 5, 7, 9 are odd numbers. Sum of the first, how many odd numbers? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So sum of the first n odd numbers is equal to n square. In the same pattern, sum of the first 5 odd numbers will be equal to 5 square, which is equal to 25. I already gave this point in your CW. Here, how many odd numbers are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the sum of the first 10 odd numbers will be equal to 10 square, and the value of 10 square is 100. Value of 10 square is 100. Next, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So sum of the first 12 odd numbers will be equal to 12 square, which is equal to 144. That means when you add all these numbers, the result will be equal to 144. Instead of that addition, we are making use of the properties of squares. Hope you understood, children. And now the eighth one, eighth and ninth, we'll finish this. Eighth one is, express 49 as the sum of 7 odd numbers. They already gave it. How many should be there? 7 odd numbers. So we have to add the first 7 odd numbers, that is 1 plus, 3 plus, 5 plus, 7 plus, 9 plus, 11 plus, 13. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Next, here how many are there? Express 121 as the sum of 11 odd numbers. So first 11 odd numbers, 1 plus, 3 plus, 5 plus, 7 plus, 9 plus, 11 plus, 13 plus, 15 plus, okay, I'm writing down, 17 plus, 19 plus, 21. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So sum of the first 11 odd numbers will give the value of 121. Okay, children. Now the last question. How many numbers lie between squares of the following numbers? That means they are asking, if we take 12 square and 13 square, you will get some value. In between 12 square and 13 square, how many numbers will be there? For that, I already told this one. We know that, write like this as I am writing. We know that numbers between n square and n plus 1 whole square, n square and n plus 1 whole square will be equal to 2 times n. Here, if you take 12, so 12 square, 12 plus 1, 13 square. So what is the n value here? 12. So 2 times 12 is equal to 24. 2 times 12 is equal to 24. Here also, what is the n value? 25. So 2 times 25 is equal to 50. And here what is n? 99. So 2 times 99 is equal to 198. So this ends up the first exercise, children. Just as I did, you copy carefully into CW. We'll meet you in the next class.